Successive generations of believers at Cypress Lake United Methodist Church have dreamed, planned, and prepared for its continuing role in ministry and mission. Now the torch is ours to faithfully grow to serve the new faces and families that are looking to this congregation to provide opportunities for knowing Christ in a deeper, more passionate, more practical way in their daily lives.
And one of the things that we noticed right off is that this was a church that welcomed people, loved to share with one another.
I've invited a few people, and once you start inviting people, they start inviting people, and your youth program grows.
And we're always willing to pray over people and help people, and you know, the spiritual strength of the church and the welcoming feeling you get is going to help them and grow their strength and their faith.
Seems as if there's several new young couples joining each Sunday, and it's really pretty exciting just to, you know, see young families, you know, coming along and the word spreading.
They know they have a place that they can come, they can be themselves, they can be safe, they can express themselves, and they know that they're going to be accepted and loved here.
The need for more physical space at Cypress Lake is seen daily. Worship capacity is beginning to limit growth. Public areas for fellowship before and after worship are sorely limited. For families with small children, the nursery facilities are located far from the sanctuary and are difficult to find. Finding meeting space for Bible studies and other small group ministries is a daily challenge. In short, Cypress Lake United Methodist is growing as it serves more people.
We have a growing number of people who are willing to serve. There's a greater depth of spirit in the people, I think.
They're inviting their friends, and we have new faces here every week. And so it's grown from just a few core students over the year to a group of 30 plus, and it just keeps growing, and it's really exciting.
Things have just blossomed tremendously over the years. We've been amazed. And
spreading the spirituality. Working among, within the community, making things happen in the name of Jesus.
The Bible study, I think, being on some committee work, I just think it helps you to grow because you start to see, you know, how your Christian faith can work.
What does the Bible say about church involvement? It tells us to meet together as believers and to encourage one another. In Hebrews it says, let us not give up meeting together, as some are in the habit of doing, but let us encourage one another, and all the more as you see the day approaching. God wants us in fellowship with other believers, to grow in faith, to learn to serve, to love one another, and to practice forgiveness. Though we are individuals, we still belong to one another. The Apostle Paul reminded the Thessalonian church, therefore, encourage one another and build each other up, just as in fact you're doing.
I think the church, at least this church, provides a comfort zone for people. They come here and they are accepted. People care about what they're going through.
You see the church in action, and I think using my sister-in-law as a real good example, the prayers that have gone out for her and her illnesses, it's super.
The kindness and the warmth that is here and the giving that we have seen has been such an example for everybody who comes here.
In a time when things are challenging for many families, this church offers a lot, not only with the relationships with others, but also with a good message. And so it's important to have a good solid foundation, whether you're blessed with great opportunities now or dealing with a trial or a challenge. This church has something to offer everyone.
When you don't have a lot of family around, you know, there's no one really speaking for you, and I couldn't walk or move around or do anything. So she came on board and Sammy came to visit me, and it was just, you know, it really made me feel like they were family coming to visit me. And this is my church home.
What part is God prayerfully calling you to play in ensuring this congregation's ongoing service? If we're to continue growing to serve, then it's up to each one of us, sacrificially, to answer the call. How is God working through you.
God will work through us. So I'm hoping that everybody will just continue to say, yes, I'm willing to be a part of it. I'm willing to ask what God wants me to do, and I'm willing to respond to whatever He calls me to.
In order for things to continue to grow, it's our time to invest.
So it's a way that I see that they can give back to this church, to God, as a way to just leave their legacy, because a legacy has been left with them.
And as our church grows and our youth hopefully grow, we'll need facilities that are welcoming to them.
As we've grown, we need to accommodate more. But it's the faith of those who come before us is why we're here today.
If you have a vision for what God can do, God will challenge you and cause you to do what you think is impossible.
Thank you for giving to the Lord. For I am a life that was changed.